What's going on, everybody? It's your boy Cornelius Jones, and I'm back, but this time got a different subject. That's right, we are going to have a conversation today with our atheists, people who period of time watch my videos from time to time, and these people believe that there is no God. Those of you out there, if you do not believe that God exists, that there is enough evidence to believe in a God or whatever, this is a video for you because I have a profound question. It is a very simple question. I believe it is a fair question. And I would like to have some conversations in the inbox, in the threads. You know, I'm even, at this point, I'd like to email whatever. I want to have some conversation with some of you. I want to ask a very simple question. What would it take for you to believe? That's the question. What would it take for you to believe? It is my concern that for some of you, there's no amount of evidence that would be reasonable enough for you to believe that God exists. Enough for you to believe that Jesus Christ, more specifically, rose again from the dead and proved himself to be God. But that can be proven wrong. You can prove me wrong. You can prove me wrong. Not that you have the desire to prove me wrong or would care to prove me wrong, but it is a factual statement that if you chose to, you could prove me wrong. And why do I say that? Because my purpose for coming on here today is to tell you about an event that many believe is in our near future. What I can guarantee is that this event will take place. I cannot guarantee when, although many people, even top scholars of today, agree that this time is near for this particular event that I'm about to tell you about. God is going to send two prophets. Two prophets to preach the gospel of Jesus Christ on this earth with magnificent fashion. They are going to prophesy, they are going to preach, they are going to witness the resurrection of Jesus Christ, and they are going to be troublesome to the world. Okay? The world is not going to receive these two prophets, but these two prophets will be sent by God, and many will try to harm these two men. And they will have power to defend themselves in ways that are unlike anything we've ever known before. Fire, sending plagues to the earth, ceasing the rain, holding the rain, it won't rain again until I say it can rain. Things like that. Where it's obvious that the power of God is on these two prophets and they are preaching the truth of Jesus Christ and it is eating the people alive because they refuse to believe. And they're being tormented by these prophets. Well, these prophets are going to meet their end, seemingly, to the world. Because the world leader, this up-and-coming world leader of this day, whatever day where these prophets are speaking on the earth, this new up-and-coming world leader is going to rise to power and kill these two prophets. And the world is going to follow. And the world is going to celebrate. The world is going to send gifts to one another. It's going to be a world thing. The world is going to celebrate the death of these prophets. They will not even be allowed to be put in graves. because their bodies will lay in the street for the world to see. And they will mock the prophets and they will celebrate the seeming victory. 3.5 days, these men of God are going to lay dead in the street. And on that, after 3.5 days, they're going to jump to their feet. They are going to be resurrected. The irony of this is they're going to be killed, in the exact same spot where Jesus was crucified. In the exact same spot Jesus was crucified, in the exact same spot where Jesus rose, these prophets are going to die. The same place. You don't think that's a coincidence, huh? These prophets that are prophesying the truth about the life of Christ in his resurrection will be overcome. They will die, lay dead 3.5 days, and be resurrected. As if that's not enough, the entire world will hear a voice from heaven say, "Come up here." And the two prophets will ascend to heaven before their enemies' eyes. In the same hour, there's going to be an earthquake where 1/10 of the city of Jerusalem is going to be destroyed and fall. It's going to kill 7,000 people. Now, my question to you is, if you see these things happening, will you remember this video? When you see a resurrection for yourself, if you are one of those men or women who are celebrating the death of these prophets, and you see them die and you see them raise, if you see a resurrection with your own eyes, is that enough? Would that be enough to persuade you? The same resurrection from the prophets that were preaching about Christ, would that be enough to persuade you then that Jesus is the Son of God? That through his blood shed on the cross, you can believe and have eternal life. Through his blood, you can have forgiveness and grace applied to all of your sins simply by just believing it. If you see a resurrection with your own eyes, could you believe then? That's my question. If you saw a resurrection with your own eyes, could you believe then? And if your answer is not an emphatic yes, there's something wrong with you. That's what I said. So, I'd like to have some conversation. I really would. If you saw a resurrection, would that be enough? Is seeing a resurrection with your own eyes convincing enough? We don't have to get into the back and forth about whether this prophecy is going to come to pass or not. I guess we gonna see. I believe it is my opinion, and also the opinion of many, many people in this world who study end times and things of that nature. But I believe if you're 40 years old or younger, you are going to be alive when these events take place. When these two prophets are sent to the earth. These two prophets are God's last warning to the world. It's your last chance. Come to Christ. Repent of your sins. Believe on the gospel and receive the Spirit of God and inherit eternal life. Last chance. That's what these prophets are sent for. last chance. And when you see these things happen with your own eyes, will you remember this video? And you know you saw this video that warned you before you saw it, and then you actually see it. Will that be enough to believe the truth? At what point do you convince your mind and are able and skilled enough to reason what the truth is? Would that be enough? Well, I pray it would be enough. Because unfortunately for some, it still won't be enough. That's a heart issue. It's not about reason. It's a heart issue. That's a soul issue. Oh, but atheists don't believe we have a soul. This body is not who you are. If I chop off my arm, my arm is dead. I still live. Why? Because I am not my arm. This, you have a soul that is inside of this body. I didn't mean to get into all that. Please join me in the comments. Let's engage. Would you believe that Jesus rose again from the dead? If you saw a resurrection with your own eyes, would that be enough to believe? That's my question. I want to see who answers the question. Regardless of how you answer it, just answer it. Be truthful. As truthful as you can. Answer the question. Let's have a dialogue. This is Cornelius Jones. I'm signing off. I'll check with y'all later on the next video. Be blessed. Love you in the Lord. Take care.